conditions. God is conditioning the nations and the church for a harvest that we cannot comprehend. It will be so great. In Isaiah 62, we're very familiar with it. Behold, darkness shall cover the earth, great darkness, the people, but. Isn't it great to have some buts in there? But the Lord shall arise upon you, and his glory shall be seen upon you. The Gentiles shall come to your light, and the abundance of the sea, humanity, the abundance of humanity will be converted to you. Oh, hallelujah. That's the other side. But we're going to have to take a stand. We're going to have to take a stand on God's word. It is God's word. It's true, and it must be obeyed. You know, God has a secret weapon. It's called the heavenly hosts. There are many warfare angels and other warrior angels that are prepared for this battle. They are ready and eager to take on the Nephilim and other fallen angels. These warfare angels have been reserved and trained for this day and age. You see, when David came against this giant called Goliath, who was a Nephilim, David said this. He said, then David said to the Philistine, you come against me with a sword. I come against you with a spear and a shield, and a sword and a shield, but I'm going to come against you in the name of the Lord of hosts. He didn't just say the name of the Lord. He said, I'm going to come against you with the Lord and his warfaring angels. Wow. Whom you have defied. And this day the Lord will deliver you into my hand, and I will smite you and take your head from off you, and I will give your carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day to the fowls of the air. You know, secret weapon. The Lord of hosts is with us. We're going to have to be very, very much aware of the angels with us in the days that lie ahead, starting this year. We need to be aware that we're not alone. We're not alone in this. David said, you come against me with sword and spear, but he said, hey, I've got an army behind me. You know, I could just imagine when David took that sling, he was getting ready to fire it. One of the angels caught it and went whack. Might have happened that way, but I like it. The final battle is looming and will empower his true people like never before. Great lawlessness coming on the face of the earth. But we have a secret weapon. You know, in Sodom and Gomorrah, when it said the whole city of homosexuals were wanting to get into the house, those angels that then thought sized up the situation, opened the door and went, phew, and they were all blind. Imagine, all of them were blind. You see, if God be for us, who can be against us? We're living in terribly dark days, but we have a great God who has an army of light, which is joining with us in this final battle. Oh, yeah. God has reserved the greatest weapons for this generation. However, the greatest weapon of all is that of love. Our motivations always must be of love. When Joshua killed men, women, and children and the animals, it was because of love. He didn't want thousands of years of the human race contaminated. It was redemptive. He had to do this to redeem the rest of humanity. That's how God is.